Good morning. Any day that Network Rail say come and don some orange PPE is a good day as far as I'm concerned, because it means I get to go and look at some new railway piece of infrastructure. So we're just down the way from Ramsgate between here and Minster to check out a brand new station that's being built, Thanet Parkway.
This new SouthEastern station is on the line between Ramsgate and Minster. It's actually almost on the same spot as a long-forgotten disused station halt that was here between 1908 and 1933. The new Thanet Parkway station will serve a new development site in the Cliffsend area, as well as being a convenient parkway station for the whole Thanet area. Construction started in 2021 and is scheduled to be completed later in 2022, but it won't actually open until May 2023 for reasons that we'll discuss later. And so after our induction and safety briefing, it was time to head out onto site, and the friendly face of this Chris greeted me, as I am of course here at Network Rail's Invite.
Morning, Chris.
Hi, Jeff.
Thank you.
Nice to see you again.
Now there is, you can see, there's an arch here away under the railway. This was a public footpath. It's closed at the moment. They're using it for access to get to the other side. Saves them having to build something over the railway, but this will be reinstated as a public. Oh, there's quite a good echo. This will be reinstated. Hello! Good echo. Oh, great echo. Let's do it again. Hang on. Hello! That's a really good echo. This will be reinstated as a public footpath when the station is finished. Climbing up the steps, up to the platform. I'm assuming these steps are just temporary.
Yeah,
I'm joking, I know they are. So the new station is being built whilst trains are travelling through at line speed. They're not slowing down. Liam's giving them a wave. Here comes the train. Chris, considering that where we're standing was just like earth and an embankment, how do they go from like an earthy embankment to what we're now?
Well, last time I was here, this was literally just a railway embankment, and they were starting piling. You basically put a screw into the ground, create a little column of concrete with steel reinforcing bars going up through it. And basically what that does is it supports the weight of the platform. So these platforms, although they look like they're sitting on the railway embankment, they're actually not. They're sitting on concrete columns that go all the way down into the clay underneath it all, because the embankment is just simply not built for this kind of job.
Liam was telling me that they didn't get planning permission on building a footbridge, because what's happened is that the railway's quite high up here, they've already climbed up the embankment to be at the level of the railway, and then the clearance has to be, I think it's 5.5 meters, and that would have been quite an eyesore to have a footbridge then already over the railway, or that's already quite high up. So hence it was handy that footbridge we saw earlier was already there, because that will allow you to get through to that side. Is this the westbound or the eastbound? What are we calling it?
The down line, and that's the up line.
So we're on the down, and over there is the up. But here we've got a waiting shelter.
This is the main waiting shelter across the network, so you have four per platform. There's four per platforms of eight in total.
It's quite a long platform. Is it a 12 car?
It is a 12 car, yeah.
That's
250
quite long,
meters,
isn't it?
Yeah.
How long is that in meters?
250.
This lady is Jennifer, whom I last met on a Citybeam 707 train. You're excited, right?
New station,
first one since when? Tell us why you're excited about Thanet Parkway.
First one since 2007, when we had Ebbsfleet International. We've had new stations at Rochester and Strood, but not a brand new station. So encourage, to support the housing development, bring people in from the local area, encourage people back to rail again. Nearly 300 car parking spaces, 60 EV points, local bus service, cycle route, pedestrian routes, so lots of different ways you can travel to and from the station as well.
There's another javelin about to whiz its way through, like this. I didn't ask Jen on purpose there just then. SouthEastern don't know yet. They don't know what the stopping pattern is going to be in terms of timetable. Will it be like two trains an hour or an hourly service, or will there be more in the peak? But it will be the high-speed trains, but the scheduling has yet to be determined. It's got me thinking, though. I'm fairly sure when you're going through the midway towns of like Rochester and Chatham, the line speed there is quite low. So weirdly, is it a case if you're at Ramsgate, Margate, it's quicker to drop down on a high-speed train through Canterbury, through Ashford, and then up the high-speed lines? I think that's a faster way of going, which is making me wonder, would it be around Birchington or Herne Bay? Where's the tipping point? Where's the halfway like between like it's quicker to go one way into London or quicker to go sort of the wrong way round into London. I should probably look it up, or if you know, put it in the comments. We're going to walk down right to the end. Right to the end. Liam, you look like a man with a really interesting fact.
Just to explain a bit of a change in this one. So in this location here, you can see the screw piles either side, and you've got sheet piles. This is where a live water main is running through. And we've got a 6 metre easement either side of the main, which was agreed with Southern Water. So hence the reason why you see the larger beam in this location, because it's spanning a lot more than what the screw pile situation is.
And that wasn't a surprise to you? There's an assessment is done before the build happens, so
correct.
You know that this is something that has to be dealt
yeah,
with.
Yeah, so it's all designed throughout the phasing.
So now you're in like the easy bit. All the planning's been done, everything, and now it's just like putting everything in place. This is the simple part.
Putting the bolts together now.
YouTube, what happens in making one of these videos is that I turn up and I literally, like, you think I know a lot about the railway, but I do just point my camera in people's faces and then we have conversations off camera. So Chris has just been like, hey Jeff, do you see this? And I'm like, well, no, hang on, that's like a clear thing which I need to get on camera. That's a really interesting thing. So Chris has done exactly that. You've told me about the Conrail heating element. What is that, Chris?
So in the southeast, where we have the live rail, the conductor rail,
the third rail and wintry icy conditions.
Yeah, so when ice forms on the top of it, ice is an insulator as opposed to a conductor, which is weird but physics, and it means the trains can't draw power. So in parts of our network, such as junctions or stations where trains are pulling away, we have conductor rail heating, which is literally a thin metal strip runs along the inside of the rail. And then when it's really cold, we turn the power onto it, and it basically keeps the rail free from ice.
Hang on, but now I've got to ask the question: where does the power to power the heating strip come from?
I'll show you the box.
That's off the question.
I'll show you the box. It's got a switch in it, and that's where it comes from.
But I like your off the cuff, you know, because physics.
Because physics.
Because we should have that as a line. If there's anything complicated, we do it because physics. I think we're waiting for one more train to come through, but it's not going to happen. We're just about to head off site. A great question which I just asked was, if you're building a new station, surely that adds into the overall journey time for existing journeys from Ramsgate up to London, but that's not the case. A weird thing is that this station will be ready before it's open because of some upgrading that's going to happen to ensure that overall journey times aren't increased. To talk about that, Chris and I are going to head down to the level crossing that's just down there in the distance. So we've come down the road to Fodes Hill in Cliffs End Village. I'm looking both ways because I'm walking across Cliffs End Level Crossing. A level crossing which is half barriers only, and the level crossing, I understand, Chris, is being upgraded, and this is an essential part of the new station. Why do the level crossings need to be upgraded before the new station can open?
Well, the main reason is that the way an automatic half barrier crossing works is that it's timed, so you get 27 seconds from when the train reaches its striking in point, which will be down there somewhere and up there somewhere, until it crosses the road. So when that yellow light comes on, until the train reaches the crossing, 27 seconds. Now, we've got a station being built just down there, well within sight. If a train pulls into that station and stops for, I don't know, a minute to load and unload people, it would have triggered the level crossing. The level crossing would have come down. It would have then timed out, raised its barriers again because no train was there, it didn't happen, it thinks the train has disappeared, and then the train would start coming from the station and we'd have mayhem. So, and before we open that station, before trains stop there, we're going to have to replace this entire crossing with full barriers and CCTV so it can be controlled manually by us.
So the station can't open until the crossings are complete, so the crossing work needs to happen too. But am I right in thinking that no time will be lost on the timetable through the new station opening because time will be gained here? Is that correct?
Yeah, so basically before we open the station, before we can get trains stopping there, we've got to do two things. We've got to upgrade the level crossing, and there's another one on the other side that we're doing something similar to but not exactly the same. And we've also got to do line speed improvements. We've done a lot of them already, but we haven't quite finished them. So the idea is a train sits at, well, say every train that calls at Thanet Parkway is going to take an extra 2 minutes, roughly 2 minutes. What we've got to do is find 2 minutes somewhere in the railway between here and Ashford that we can claw back so that the trains that do stop here don't lose any time.
As if on cue, the barrier gates are going down. It's weird seeing little, tiny little gates and not full barrier gates nowadays.
So this time next year, full barrier gates, CCTV, much better.
Okay, I guess we leave with a closing shot of the train passing through.
So that sounds a great way of finishing.
Thanks, everybody. Bye. Say bye. It's a train.
Bye.
Bye.